In this video, you'll see how to use AWS Cost Explorer with AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, or AWS DRS. With Cost Explorer, you can gather cost and usage data for the DRS service, break down the monthly and daily costs, and create a report to forecast the cost and usage of the service. To get started, let's navigate to AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. Notice that we currently have 52 source servers that are replicating and being protected by DRS. To help streamline the process of estimating and forecasting our DRS costs, we can tag our resources. Let's go to Settings to take a look at our custom tags. We can select Edit to view the default replication settings. The settings include one custom tag for the replication server. If we wanted, we could create more. For now, we'll retain these settings and move on. Next, let's navigate to Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2. To look at some of the resources DRS is using. Let's look at our running instances. We have several AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery replication servers running. Let's select one of them to view its tags. This server has a tag named AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Managed. This is one of the default tags that we're going to leverage in Cost Explorer. Let's check another server to see if it has the same tag. As expected, it does. Next, let's take a look at the Elastic Block Store, or EBS, volumes. We'll sort this list by name in order to find the DRS resources. Let's select a server and view its tags. This resource also has the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Managed tag. Let's check another one. Here's the tag again. Next, let's view the EBS snapshots, which are the third resource we're looking for. We'll select one of the snapshots and view its tags. This resource is also tagged AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Managed. Next, we'll make sure this tag has been designated as a cost allocation tag. Let's navigate to Billing. In the list of user-defined cost allocation tags, we can see the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Managed tag. It's already active, but for the purposes of this example, let's go through the process of activating it. Note that it can take up to 24 hours for a tag to become fully active. Now let's navigate to AWS Cost Explorer and take a look at the cost breakdowns. Here we can see our last 6 months of billing, including DRS costs, as well as costs for other AWS services we're using. We can select a bar on this graph to see the cost for a specific service that month. For example, the DRS cost for January 2022 was $1,083.26. The DRS costs shown here are only for the replication service. If we want to include the other resources DRS is using, we'll need to make use of the cost allocation tag we activated earlier. Here's the tag. Notice that we have two tags to choose from here. The one listed as No Tag Key includes resources tagged prior to the activation of the cost allocation tag and will not include detailed data. For our purposes, we'll look at the resources tagged after the activation of the tag. Because we just activated the tag, we can only see a point on the graph. Let's narrow the date range to better see the data. We'll set the time range to the last 7 days. Now we can see costs for two resources, EC2 Instances and EC2 Other. Let's group this by usage type. Now we can see all the different usage types for these particular DRS resources. Let's change this to a bar graph to break it down more. If we'd like to go even deeper, we can switch the view from monthly to daily. Note that any resource DRS makes use of will be tagged with the relevant cost allocation tag, and the cost will show up here. It's important to be aware of which region you are filtering on, as well as your replication server usage type when interpreting the data. Let's take a look at this teal-colored bar for June 4th, where we can see a total cost of $2.52. This is for all the T3 small replication servers we're using. Next, we'll look at the EBS snapshot costs. For all 52 servers, there's essentially one volume for each, which is only costing us 98 cents per day. Finally, let's examine the cost of the usage of those EBS volumes. As you can see, it's costing us 76 cents per day. Let's clear the grouping and tags. Let's group by service. We'll change the view back from stack to bar. Here we can see the DRS costs for each day. For June 2nd, it's costing $34.94 per day for the 52 servers that we're replicating. This is made up of the hourly rate per source server. From this page, we can also download the CSV and export the file for reporting. You've just seen how to use AWS Cost Explorer with AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.